Good evening, everyone. Today, we are delighted to have with us a farmer, an entrepreneur, an agripreneur, a visionary, a motivational speaker, and a mentor to many, Mr. Anand Chaudhary.
Thodi si
pet puja, ya fir khane banaye mazedar. I'm sure every household has either their pickle or a packet at their home. With a 600 crore plus turnover and presence in 25 countries internationally, we have the Director of Technology and Innovation of Praveen Masala with us today. He tick boxes so many sustainable development goals simply by following practices such as waste to health, empowering flower, empowering farmers, focusing on green buildings. Did you all know 40% of India, of food is wasted in India, valuing to about 92,000 crores per annum? Passionate about a greener, healthier, sustainable and prosperous India, he started the Eco Factory Foundation in 2017. It's India's first ever waste management park to provide sustainable lifestyle solutions to rural and urban communities. He has established centers for urban gardening and farming. He's also creating Green Pages, India's first ever waste management directory with the compilation of green recyclers and processors. Coinciding with the ethos of sustain and save, be the change, not the problem. He believes he wants to be the change you want to see in the world. He's the recipient of many awards from all over the world, like and even countries like UK, Belgium, and all across India. He holds numerous positions in various chambers of commerce and has been invited as a motivational speaker on various forums. I think I can go on and on speaking about him. And now we have him today. I'm so happy to welcome you, sir, for our lovely talk on sustainability. To just do a little introduction on Sustain and Save, a lot of people ask me, what have we started with Sustain and Save? It's actually a one-stop solution on sustainability created by Indians for the world. We at Sustain and Save believe in creating corporate impact by bridging the gap and connecting green product and green services to individuals and companies all across the world. Our knowledge and resource inspiration, which focus on social impact, includes various sustainable initiatives and inspiring stories. And today we have an inspiring story with him. Using our 3R principle of re-innovation, redefinition, and being responsible, we aim to achieve affordable sustainability and circular economy. Started on the 22nd April 2020 during the lockdown, this Earth Day, by the Shroff sisters, Pranati and Ankita Shroff, who are both entrepreneurs and who have completed their diploma from Swedish Institute in Responsible Leadership and Sustainable Businesses. Today, we have a team of 100 plus young change makers from all across the world, which is India, Singapore, UK, and America. In less than 2 months, we've had collaborated with companies like IKEA, the Swedish government, CII, IGBC, and onboarded 20 plus companies on sustainability as our channel partners and 5 plus educational institutions. Our first month focus was on a 21-day challenge and then creating awareness on green products like bamboo, women hygiene, houseware cutlery, organic wellness. This month is focused on waste management along with recycling strategies. And I think, sir, your Eco Factory Foundation is a perfect example which fits in inspiring the youth of our country to tell them the importance of sustainability for our future. Thank you, sir, and hope, Didi, I take you to take this forward. Thank you.
Welcome, Anand, sir. We're really, really glad that you joined us today. And I'm sure you're going to be really inspirational for most of the youth who joined. And of course, inspiration for those who are from the food industry who have also joined to do such factories or do such events. So I'm an architect and an environmental consultant. So I definitely know that passion and the way you've been working on your project. So how did the whole business begin? And if you could quickly elaborate on that.
Thanks that you have been remembering us through the products in the lockdown time also. So I'm glad for that, actually. And I think it is putting too much pressure on me the way Ankita has introduced me. I'm just doing some small little work for the planet. And that's what I believe. It's so logical and eco-friendly. And that's what I call it. It's ecological, you know. So that's the work which Eco Factory Foundation is doing right now. As far as the story of Suhana or Praveen Masale Wale goes, yes, it is started by my grandfather and grandmother in 1962. Grandfather used to sell the products which she used to make at home. So it was a very humble, small beginning. That's how they started growing, and by understanding customers better, by valuing customers better, creating the right products for the right markets. This is how we have grown so far. Initially near, just in Pune, then around Pune, and then Maharashtra, then across India, and now almost in 24 countries we are working. We are third generation in the business. Myself and my brother Vishal, we both look after spices and the pickles business. Dad and grandfather always has been a big blessing and a guiding force. And in-house, we never had to outsource inspiration. We had the inspiration in-house. So that's in-house. What the biggest role which they have played for us in a big way. We offer more than 180 products today. We no more masala company. We offer a lot of food solutions. We offer instant mixes. We offer health foods. In fact, the pandemic times, our turmeric latte product, which has been designed specially from our traditional Indian haldi doodh recipe, which to me is a super food, we have converted into a beautiful product, and it is catching a good fire in the market right now. So COVID time in many ways has been a blessing. So like a new normal we all have found for business. For me personally, I have found a new me in the COVID, because there has been so much of introspection on the self and work on the self, and introspection for the future and getting future ready in all sense for the business and for the green work. So that's been us so far. I hope it was helpful.
Yes, I think that was really sweet and very humble of you saying, "Hey, I'm Chotis, you know, we're doing this little thing that we do." Moving straight to the sustainable story that everybody is really looking forward to. The first one on that would be the Suhana warehouse at Bhubaneswar that you did in 2018, right? It's a platinum certified building. And a small story of how you thought about it and all about it.
Oh, so fortunately, when the warehouse was happening, so I just want to give everyone some background. We have been doing warehousing through outsource or through a rental buildings as to dispatch and distribute our products in the market, which we decided to have our own infrastructure, because the rental premises were not sufficient and the operations there were not very lean and also safe or eco-friendly as well. And I happened to get into my first greenfield project, and that was our own Bhubaneswar warehouse. Before this, always what we had with us was traditionally which the family was looking into and grown. But Bhubaneswar was a first conceptualized and designed factory premise or a warehouse premise by me and a team. And at the same time, the formation of Eco Factory Foundation had happened. So, and it was the foundation formation is actually a side effect of the decision or the resolution I had passed in our industry, that we will not produce any waste per se. And if we produce any waste, we will make a point to recycle, upcycle, refurbish that waste. Because to me, it always has been that waste is some sort of wealth or source of energy. So why do we waste, throw that waste we produce? And when we were studying about the waste we were generating in our premises, we audited what all we produce, what all things we can do with that. I realized that we have learned so much just to manage our own waste, and not that everything is useful to me, but there are many things I learned which are useful to everyone else in the society, and I need some structure to offer that to society as much as I can, because I keep learning more and more every day about managing waste efficiently. And Eco Factory Foundation became a right vehicle to, or a tool to take whatever we've been learning to the society. Now, when this was happening parallelly in my professional life of Suhana or Praveen Masale Wale, my first greenfield project, which was our Bhuleshwar warehouse, Suhana Global Warehouse, was happening. And so, of course, it's like connecting the dots. And ideas which influence you in your life, of course, you want to see that how you can implement those ideas into every aspect of your life. So, may it be your home, may it be your personal life, may it be your companies you're working at. And that's how the idea came, that we will make this place a completely eco-friendly place. And believe me, when I was doing that place, I had no clue about IGBC or such ratings exist in the world of architecture and real estate and buildings, because I was a complete passionate go green, go clean, go lean man, and I was clear that I want to achieve it come what may. I want to make sure not a single gram of wastage goes out of that building, or not a single milliliter of water will be wasted. That was with a logic and clarity, I was just designing that place, and the whole project got executed like that, and we met very good people in the journey. And that's where I believe that when your intentions are very good and you want to do something better for community, planet, the entire cosmos works for you. That's how some right people automatically jumped into the project, and we could create something even I don't believe that we have created. And it's a beautiful place to witness. It has become a forest now. I have a warehouse, and around the warehouse, you can see in last 6 years, we are actually able to create a proper forest, and lot part of that has become like a food forest now. A good achievement, even in COVID times, or a bit prior, during COVID times happened, is we had done lot of work on water conservation on that site, since it had some good slopes behind the site, and we tried to do some trenching work and applied some principles of water harvesting. And after these 4-5 years, whatever water harvesting we have been able to do, we are getting very good quality water at a very better levels underground. So underground water levels actually are increased in that area because of the work we have been doing, and now we have got a good source of water to do more greening and more cleaning there. So many such things, small things, are implemented there, and we have done a very interesting learning from IGBC also. We got that one of the aspect also is always seen in the buildings is how the workmen's are how work friendly, and there is a better environment is been created for people who are working on the site, and we could do a lot on that after that enlightenment to us that yes, the way we look at nature, and humans are also part of nature, so we must do something for the way humans are treated and the facilities we could have there. So it's a very holistically done building. The solar panels are fitted on the parking area, and that's what that power is used actually to run the entire place.
I can see the passion. You can go on and on. It's like you can tell us.
Sorry, I'm not giving you a chance to ask any next questions.
I think you are typically covering what I have to ask you. Like, I was going to ask you about circular economy, the whole circular economy versus the linear approach how you did it and stuff. But I think you kind of
I'll share best. That in detail. If that's the next thing you want me to answer it.
Yes.
Okay. So so warehouse is still a limited operation where packed products go, and the packed product is dispatched. But then when we understood these concepts, which are very important, we realized they're valuable. And as I said, that when we decided to go a waste-free premise and industry, and the idea was from where to start. And it was so clear that I would like to do anything and everything on my premise. So failure bhi aana hai to apne premise pe aane denge, success bhi aana hai to apne premise pe aane denge. That's a better way than going out and telling, hey, this is what we all should do. Better do it and then show the example to people. So then we started implementing that entire concept even at the factory level. And we generate a lot of waste as food industry. We जैसे मिर्ची को क्लीन किया, हल्दी को क्लीन किया, तो उसमें का कचरा निकलेगा. लॉट ऑफ अदर थिंग्स विल गेट जनरेटेड, प्लास्टिक विल गेट जनरेटेड एज वेस्ट ऑफ पैकिंग मटेरियल. देन द ऑलवेज क्वेश्चन वाज देयर, व्हाट वी डू अबाउट इट. सो एज आई सेड, द वेरी बेसिक थिंग वाज ऑडिट द वेस्ट, व्हाट वी प्रोड्यूस, व्हेन वी प्रोड्यूस, कुछ सीजनल वेरिएशंस है क्या, वॉल्यूम्स क्या है, एंड देन मेक अ प्लान फॉर ईच वेस्टेज इंडस्ट्री लाइक आज इज प्रोड्यूसिंग. Including, let's say, when we make pickles, we generate a lot of the seeds of the kerry, bata bolte usko, kerry ka bata as waste. More than 3,000 tons of bata we produce every year. And in our spice industry, we produce more than 4,000 tons of wastage as well. And then isme tamal patte ki stick aayi, yeah, aise so many things will be there, which are many things are our kitchen waste also every day. Then we figured out a way that how to go about this. And how to add value to this, and is there any hidden value in the waste we have? So pre-composting or putting it back into a composter or soil, what are the ways and means we can get more value added stuff out of the things we are generating as waste, and then let them go back to the soil. But the crux always has been that all the things we consume in the city area as our food, and we generate a lot of organic waste, should go back to soil, because we are actually taking things out from the soil. And it's really important, which I have also shared in my TEDx talk, that the topsoil and importance of organic carbon content in the soil, and how really that plays extremely vital role in all aspects of environment. And many things are known to us, and many I'm sure are still unknown to science. Although we feel we are very advanced. So, but the nature works in that perfection, and I believed always in that. And so we decided to have a complete circular approach to, let's say, plastic waste we generate, what to do about it. The farm waste we generate, which is like cow dung or other things, what to do about that. And the biodegradable waste which we generate, where if it is high cellulose, how to look at it. If it is low cellulose, how to look at it. If it has more simple carbohydrates, can we do something else, because it can be easier material to compost and generate biogas with. So all these aspects, talking with many NGOs, many scientists, many experts, seeing interesting films on YouTube, and passionately learning from anything and everything around me, that's how the journey was evolved. Today I'm very happy to share. So I don't know very current figures, but the time I gave TED talk, that time I had calculated everything, and by that time 1400 truckloads of waste we had recycled, reused, or repurposed in some or the other way. And I'm very happy to share that most of our facilities are completely waste free, or I can say that we manage our waste on the site very efficiently, or wherever it is required to be handed over to the right partner, we hand it over to the right partner. For plastics, what we did was, we have put an oil machine and we extract the oil from plastic. And that plastic oil is used in our boilers as a fuel. So many times people have this question, ki plastic ka kya kiya? वो बड़ा डेंजरस बात है. तो हाँ, वो डेंजरस है, और वो हम बहुत सेंसिटिवली यूज भी करते हैं और उसको ट्रीट भी करते हैं उतना ही सेंसिटिवली.
I think I know that your company is a big company, and you're definitely have big volumes and big figures, which are kind of demonstrative of what an individual company can do and is doing. So the like 1400, I kind of lost figures at one point as to how much you have recycled. But what would be your advice, or what? How do you think could small industries do this? So this is, I know, off the track question, but from a small industries perspective.
No, I think it's not at all off the track question, and I think it is a question which I have always asked myself, and that's the reason I thought that I can't tell people that this is how things should be, and I realized that I should be implementing everything at our own premises. So after we got success at certain level, we decided that let's implement similar thing at on other premises also. And we were very fortunate, and I feel EcoFactory Foundation's birth has happened in a beautiful city called Pune, where there is so much of awareness and willingness of so many people to move and jump quickly into the green movement. So as long as we used to tell people that this is what EcoFactory does, and we are ready, and come and green your premises, manage your waste efficiently. And many institutes came forward, and ISKCON Kataraj is one of such places. SNDT Home Science College supported us by giving their area to work on. Gokhale Institute residential campus we've been working on. And these are very small campuses, but generating some sort of a different waste. But see, the basic philosophy, basic logic is just so simple, I feel. And I feel simple is replicable. And that's how I have initiated this thing, that this is easy to do approach if we can understand the principles of nature well and work adhering to those principles of nature. We can achieve this anywhere. I'm going to show you Pune campus today, that this entire 1 acre area, whatever waste we generate, I don't take anything, a gram of it outside. And I'm growing abundant food in this place. So I'll show you that later. But these are possibilities we could were able to do. And now we are working with IIT also on the similar project. We are working with many industrial estates now, that these common spaces in industrial estates can be turned out into a good green forests, and where a lot of waste also can be parallelly managed well. And now we are helping and training individual household people. Ki ek 1 BHK flat bhi hai, 2 BHK hai, society hai, row house hai, bungalow hai. How you can really integrate approach of waste to wealth and waste to health in that space. And that's what our first, India's first waste management park, which we tried to create, the EcoFactory Foundation, is meant for a complete 360 degree learning and experiential approach for managing waste efficiently, whether it is whether it is any kind of a premise. So this is very much possible, doable, and this is very simple.
So for the viewers to know about EcoFactory Foundation, is there a link that people can look at, or if you could share details so people could get back to you on that in terms of the EcoFactory Foundation that you've been working on? Let me move to the last question before we go around the campus. I believe your work-life balance and passion is quite... how do you manage the whole work-life balance and your passion?
So I was swarthy enough to make sure that whatever I do connects it somewhere the other way to my original work and business, because one is I could do a lot of different work to bring right kind of sustainable leadership for our own business and industry, but along with that I could go more closer to nature and farming, and our business is food business, which means it is all about farming and farmers. So all my idea was to stay very close to the area of farming. Yes, exactly. So anyways, I'm not really deviating myself from my core business. Rather, I'll know more deeper about my work And the reason
when there's passion, you don't have to balance anything in life, you know. That's
absolutely
there is the question.
So this is a good connection.
Balance, you
and
know?
You know what? I believe that the whole connecting dots even has happened here in my green initiatives and business also. It's all connected. And I think yes, I get great support from everyone, my near and dear one, my families who are listening right now. Many of them I know, and they have been supporting me always in doing things, because even they realize that it's so logical what's happening here, and it is even need of the hour. So that's been always a support. Yeah, so it's been a support from my kids, my wife, everyone. So
that's
and
crazy.
I have taken a one very big inspiration from my grandfather also, that he's been farming for more than 20-25 years organically. He's never put chemicals or pesticides in the soil, which also made me realize that, see, this is something we need to understand. And that's how, after the first waste management park, the second initiative Eco Factory Foundation has actually taken up is Sustainable Farming and Rural Entrepreneurship Center. Now, where we are focusing on how the farming can become a lucrative, enterprising entity, as well as by doing that, how you can manage rural waste, which is generated in rural India, or you can even absorb a lot of waste from urban spaces and make sure that your soil becomes very healthy to grow healthy food. So the idea I always share people is, I personally believe our economy should move from oil-based economy to soil-based economy.
Wow.
And India needs that approach in a very big way. And that's what EcoFactory Foundation is committed to 24/7 forever, to deliver and make sure that our soil gets back its own glory. So Eco Factory Foundation, I'll answer that question also, is a Section 8 registered company, which is a non-profit making organization. And we have our core focus is enabling sustainability, fostering sustainability in rural areas and urban areas. And we have created these two different segments to it. The reason is social, economical, geographical conditions in both the areas are completely different. So we need different approaches. Although both the places we want to adhere to principles of nature and work, then either it is urban farming, urban gardening. That's our next project which is happening. We are creating center for urban farming and urban gardening and urban food forestation at the same premises, Yavat. And I encourage, before I forget also, I encourage all to visit that premise, all the viewers.
I think if you could move to your tour or whatever you were talking about as to you wanted to show us. Yes.
So this was a barren land a year back. Last August, I have started doing some work on the soil and also on the farm front. And today, I'm very happy to share. This is a very small, probably 10,000 square feet area, which I have tried to do some farming on. And everything happens here, as I said, with the principles of nature. So we have fixed more than a ton of waste in the soil so far, and we are doing organic farming of more than 25 different crops in the Pune city residential place. And this is my second crop after the first ones I took. And for example, now this is what we try to tell farmers when we talk about sustainable farming, that how now we don't use any chemical fertilizers or synthetic insecticides, pesticides. We use things more like Jivamrut, Amrutpani, Panchagavya, which is made from farm waste, and they are extremely powerful and valuable recipes and ingredients to make your soil live and make sure that the waste we put on the soil is decomposed in a very healthy and a faster rate, which is used by plants to grow. You can see a lot of mulch here, which is all the kachra which we keep putting on the soil, and then put these bacterial cultures which are made on site from different materials which are generated in the farm. So for example, when we talk about farm sustainability or sustainable farming, these are very key principles we try to teach farmers, that even without giving these expensive inputs, you can do some things phenomenally well by just doing some basic things. Which, and to me, for that, what inspires is the way forest ecosystem works.
I think this is amazing. I think one of the first interviews where we've seen live demonstration of urban farming.
See, for this interview, I came across in the lockdown period to this place. So we have lemongrass, we have herbs, we have spices growing here, everything.
So I too have been trying organic farming, and I have been having a lot of challenges. I have been doing composting in my own bungalow. So it's loads of fun. We also managed to grow, you know, the happiness you get when you get a papaya from your own tree is of another level. So I know what it is all about. And like you said, the lockdown has been to our advantage to give more time to our own garden or our own, you know, space that we can we love. So moving to the last part of the discussion is something that we call as the rapid fire round. So let's begin. The first question: the word plants.
Plants.
Yes, plants.
Life. Life.
Okay. Life.
Okay. Life, circular economy,
logical, creative, scientific.
Okay, one practice that makes you an ambassador of green, you would say?
Think green.
One green product from your company, or like just that you would like to promote, one green product, only one. I know there are many.
All the vegetables and fruits we are growing.
Green practice.
Sustainable farming. The biggest composter. I take one minute here. The biggest composter, I feel, is Mother Earth itself. And India is blessed that we can compost on any and every surface of India throughout the year. And we must use that. So, composting, or I mean sustainable farming, is the most green practice one can do.
Yes. Things that you would like to tell the youth, like the loads of young people who are associated with Sustain and Save in the age group of 18 to 25. So that's really young.
And okay, so generally I know this question is asked. So I have answer written for this already, because I knew this question will come to me. But I have something which is very close to my heart, and I believe that it's better to have tried and failed than to live life wondering what would have happened if I had tried. So I personally believe that if there is some purpose and passion you hold in your heart, just go for it. Try it, and life will be very meaningful.
Which company which association is really something that you look up to, or you know, would like to associate with in the future?
Okay, it's association with nature and the true form of nature, and our own true form, my own true self of ours. So. Great. Yeah, that's what I feel like we should get more associated and tuned to.
Yes. I think this was brilliant. Thank you so much. So I've been truly inspired. I think he's been one person who works so closely with all the SDG goals, which is either it could be living a greener legacy for the family, because it's three generations all working towards a better cause. They're not only empowering people but making this world a better place, and I think that's something truly amazing that you know, we've heard from him, and we all need to take this path of sustainability so that either from our little homes that we have, it could be organic farming, urban farming, or composting.
To me, my biggest inspiration has been my Dada Sa. With an extreme humble beginning, he has started with lot of failures in life. More than 15-16 businesses were failed miserably, but still he was there trying hard, and now he's what he is today. In spite of all the business achievements as a person, he is absolutely संसारातले संत म्हणतो तसं व्यक्तिमत्व हुकमीचंद चोरडिया त्यांच्यावर एक मूवी पण झालेला आहे आणि देर इज अ चॅप्टर ऑन माय ग्रँड फादर्स अँड माय ग्रँड मदर्स लाईफ इन अवर एस एस सी करिक्युलम आय थिंक 8th ऑर some standard
that's,
also.
That's amazing. That's truly inspirational. So there is a question which is related to this. I think it's time you start a homeschool like for children or parents who want to learn from nature over a period of 1 year. So, you know, if they want to come and stay there and learn about it, is there a concept that you're thinking about?
Yes, we have created few rooms which are getting ready at Yavat premises, where we will look at people who are seriously interested to learn about waste management, sustainable farming, or sustainability in general in life. We have 5 rooms which we will open to people soon.
That's
a very nice question from the young entrepreneurs, because there are always barriers to start something or failures. Can you talk about the barriers that you had while starting the EcoFactory Foundation? You know, some failure, because life is not as easy as it looks, right? So can you talk about,
And life is not even easy now, so that's fine. But we can, but the idea is we can still be smiling and accepting the challenges which we keep facing and try to solve them. So the entire journey is actually inspiring me, as I said, by my grandfather. So there are still many failures, unsolved questions to manage things in a very environmental friendly way. But yes, there is a will and there will be a way. And if there is no way created by anyone, I think our intentions are so clear that to achieve, I know that the nature will work for us, and some or the other way we will find the solution and move towards it. So yes, actually telling you about the exact problems, yes, there were some serious problems we had, and even we today have, is about dealing efficiently with plastic, where it's a, and although it's environmentally sustainable in many ways, this pyrolysis technology and other things, so there are still real problems. I still see a lot of research is required in the field of waste management. At awareness level, there needs to be more awareness, and I struggle largely for getting things segregated at my factory premises also. So much of awareness still is required in people's mind, and importance of green movement needs to be created. So we keep doing that, we keep struggling on that. Whenever it comes time of plantation, or my target is to plant 1 lakh trees in next 5 years. So whenever I think about from where to source plants, how to source and do our own nursery and plant creation, I still see that there are some serious gaps which needs to be filled to make these things happen very easily. And we are right now working on that model. Because it is not very important to me from the foundation's perspective that I just do my 12 premises and I'm done. No, I want to see my nation clean, my nation green, and my nation sustainable. I want to see my state clean, my city clean, and I want to see my people empowered and enthusiastic about cleaning, greening. That's where all the levels I need to work on, and I'm trying to work.
That's really
so it's all challenges now. It's all challenges. I am struggling to find out ways and means to do it.
True.
There's another nice question. How do you see the future of organic food products in India? And what are the plans of Suhana in organic products?
See, there are 3 things in this. One is
absolutely chemically grown food where you don't even know how much chemical or insecticide, pesticides are used. That's a bit of a no-no from my side, because that actually is becoming harmful for everybody's health, farmer's health also, and consumer health also, and the soil's health also. So that's a clear no-no where we should definitely not move in. And I can see that government, state government, and also central government, both are moving towards that direction now. Today itself, the Consumer Protection Act is coming, and in that all these aspects will also come more stringently. FSSAI has already come up with organic license and etc. But there are two other ways, and there are second, third level concepts to grow food. Overall, I can say the demand for clean food will grow. The demand for right source will always grow in times to come. But then there is one way that where a specified and defined quantity of pesticide or insecticide is used and is regulated and noted down, which many FPOs and FPCs are also doing now, farm producing organization, like the grape grower. Many organizations are there who are exporting. They control it properly, so it's a control. That is somewhere which still can be a good way forward for many farmers. For someone like me, who is a complete passionate about nature and organic farming, I always see a bright prospect in that, definitely. But the farms needs to be certified, or some model and scalability needs to be there to make it a recognizable. Nahi to bahut abhi ek aur struggle kya ho raha hai? Again, answering to the earlier question, whenever there is too much of supply, sometimes the demand is less. Whenever there is too much of demand, the supply is less. So there is a lot of unevenness because there are irregularities in the markets also. And that is also very important from the perspective of organic farming, that there is a balance between demand and supply. See, in this particular area, nature is acting like a factory. It's nothing man-made. It is made by nature, nurtured by nature. So we need to believe strongly with the principles of nature and work, and we can harness the best out of it. I am very confident about it.
Amazing. I think that's a bang on answer. So I think we'll have one last question, and then I think we can say thank you. So what kind of the operational costs were reduced at Eco Factory? Because, you know, people think sustainability is expensive. Were there really any, you know, operational cost reductions when you started Eco Factory?
So operational cost reductions may not have happened, but there has been a lot of income from the products we have created from the waste. For example, I can just list few things which we are doing right now, which is very well mentioned in the TED Talk also. We have used our metal waste to create a lot of furniture items, and we are trying to sell those items also, or use in our own place. We are creating cow dung into cow dung pots, cow dung chips, cow dung bricks, and now the new trend I am seeing, cow dung Ganesha, Ganesha idols, eco-friendly, are also made with soil and use of cow dung. There is a huge ecosystem and a lot of sales of these things we do. What we do very interestingly is also we have made dhoop sticks out of cow dung and flower waste, and those are sold, and they are great products. They are great products. Lot of other cow dung products also we are working on. In the city, when we sell these farm produces or products from the waste, what we do is we sell them in either society, in different societies, door to door, or we have a couple of weekly market kind of a concept, Athavdi Bazaar concept, where we sell these products also. So, and I needed some more people, in fact. So, wo cost kam nahi hua. But lot of value addition hua, jo cow dung ki tarah istemal hota tha, wo aaj cow dung ki tarah istemal nahi hota hai. Jo factory waste ki tarah istemal hota tha, hamare abhi team ne naya research karke, we have made papers out of our onion peels and garlic peels. And those papers will be used for wrapping gifts or other things in our own organization. We'll stop buying those papers. So like that, and we other example, if you like these sticks, tamalpatra sticks I told you, and these pudina sticks, which is waste, उनको हम briquetting करते हैं and charcoal बनाते हैं. तो और weed के stick से उससे भी charcoal बनता है. More than 2000 kilo charcoal we must have made till date after getting that briquetting machine. So the and that is sold. Still there is a very big market in rural area. हमारे पास stocks इसके बचते नहीं, ये rural areas में अच्छे से sell हो जाता है. So this is also way forward in everything. I may not remember everything right now, but for everything we have done some or the other thing. Another thing we have done is biogas. So we used to do a lot of masala cooking or frying on LPG. और अभी हमारा almost महीने का 8 LPGs replace होता है biogas से. So it's also a very big contribution we got from using shen, cow dung, to generate biogas. And then that slurry which comes, that slurry is going in the farms because that slurry is very useful material to enrich the soil. So that is how circular economy is getting thoroughly implemented at all levels. So where I have not implemented, I'll tell you, is the logistic area, vehicles. I don't know how to look at all that yet now, but I think we'll figure out some ways and means to.
Amazing. You give a very nice answer by it's not about reducing your costs, it is about making waste an asset and making it as an income. So that was a very good takeaway that you gave us. I request Didi to conclude this lovely inspiring session for today.
Thank you Ankita. So I definitely thank you, Anand sir, for joining us today and inspiring the youth, inspiring everybody who want to get into the field of sustainability, because I believe that the desire is there. They need the guidance, they need the inspiration to go get it. And I think I could see that, I could see a lot of messages saying awesome, amazing, great inspiration. So I've been looking at the chat which has been talking about all that. And we really look forward to visiting your facility soon. We will be coming there soon with all the sustain and save passionate, entrepreneurs or change makers, as we call them, because they are the future and they are going to change the way we look at life. So we call all our sustain and save youth as change makers. So thank you so much for joining us.
I want to first, before you conclude, let me again share. I want to congratulate to both of you. You have taken up a great initiative, Sustain and Save. I want to wish you the best for your all future sustainable endeavors. And I'm definitely looking forward that we can also together become a great change maker. And to bring this change, we all have to unconditionally come together for one big vision, which is clean India, green India, sustainable India. No second thought should come in this. If we join hands together, learn from each other, adopt things from each other, inspire everyone, the only way to bring I always say revolution from this evolution is going to be by togetherness. One thing also, nature inspires. Everything works together in nature, and we are talking about nature. Then see where all the strengths can come together, and we give a great impact for each and every one of us.
Thank you, sir.
So I congratulate to both of you first.
Thank you so much, sir. We would love to have you as an advisor at Sustain and Save. I would definitely formally invite you, drop an email. And today was such an inspiring session for us. And we would love to have you on board and help us, guide us in our little journey of creating more impact with the youth. I would definitely drop a formal email. And thank you so much, sir.
Thank you so much. I'll be the advisor who wants to learn more than advising.
It's all about collaboration.
I'm really humbled. One of the best session I had definitely till date, and all the best. And once again, thank you to all the viewers listening to me patiently, but really want to invite you to see what we are trying to do, give your suggestions, bombard your suggestions on us, and we'll try to do the best we can do, because all we are trying to do is for community and society and not just for ourselves. So do that. Thank you so much.
Thank you,
Praniti and Ankita, once again. And to all the sustenance safety.